This is my podcast. This is my podcast. Leroy Furious, the Leroy Fury cast. This is my podcast. This is my podcast. This is my. I say what the fuck I want, bitch. Welcome to the Leroy Fury cast. I have a fan on because it's 900,000 degrees outside right now. And I feel like having it on. Anyway, I'm watching this show Black Summer on Netflix. It's about like zombies. There's an infection going on. There's a Mexican dude riding with a Korean woman in the passenger seat. And a older Caucasian lady's in the back seat. And they're tripping. And I'm turning it off because I'm not watching shit while I'm talking. Yeah, I got a lot of shit on my Netflix queue that I've already seen or I'm still watching. Like New Girl, that's a cool show. I should start this from the beginning. Yeah. Because the Prince episode is the only one I've really seen. I synced it. Damn, 7 seasons? Ooh, this is a rabbit hole. Oh, season 7 only got 8 episodes. Nice. But every other season got 20-something. New Girl could suck my new dick. This show long as fuck. I'm good. I'm gonna fuck with it. I like it. It is a funny show. Daredevil. Oh, I love Daredevil season 3. Motherfucking Bullseye, nigga. Bullseye was going ham and shit. Mr. Iglesias. Doomsday Preppers. Doomsday Preppers my shit. Doomsday Preppers my shit. Them motherfuckers crazy as hell, bro. Sherlock Holmes. Lucifer. Bucky. I don't fuck with anime like that, man. Friday Night Tykes. Fuck those coaches. This You Lie in April, The Girl from the Naked Eye. I'm just naming shit that I'm watching right now. Anyway, earlier today, I was walking around. What's today's date? Today is Monday, July 22nd, 2019. What's going on? How are ya? you get the joke. Yeah. The In-Laws, Albert Brooks movie. I never saw this one before. Albert Brooks and Michael Douglas. Oh, isn't Ryan Reynolds in that? I think Ryan Reynolds in that too. Scarface, Pulp Fiction, Philadelphia. Tom Hanks and Denzel did a movie together and I never saw it. Because I'm a fucking douchebag. Bandersnatch. Lakeview Terrace, Winona Earp. That's Wyatt Earp's daughter. She's a kung fu expert. American Horror Story Cult. My favorite one. Play, episode 6. I already saw it before, but I'm gonna watch it again anyway. Oh yeah, I saw 2 things today that were very interesting. I saw a woman riding a scooter. Like, you know, they got e-scooters now. You can just like scan your phone and ride the scooter around. And I thought that this scooter shit was amazing because the chick that was riding the scooter, she had like amazing subtle breasts. And what she did was ride the scooter on the sidewalk. And I was up around Georgetown in D.C. And like D.C., Georgetown, their road, this sidewalk's not smooth. It's kind of bumpy. So it's a chick with like huge like D-cups and a pink shirt riding the scooter down the sidewalk, the e-scooter. And it's just like, and her titties just bouncing like crazy. And I'm watching the shit like, I ain't got to work to objectify you. I don't objectify women, but sometimes I still do. But I don't do it, but sometimes I do. It's weird, but I like it. But don't do that, guys. Don't objectify women. Respect women, god damn it. Be a fucking gentleman. Don't be a dickhead. It's not nice to be a fucking dickhead to women. You gotta treat them the right way. Treat them nicely. Be kind to them and shit. I used to have this joke. I used to say the only way you could have sex with a light-skinned girl or get a light-skinned girl to like you is you got a shit in your hand and smack them in the back of the neck. Because like a lot of girls like being tortured, you know? They like being tortured by guys. That's what I think. A lot of women are like sadists, masochists. They like abuse. And I'm 5'7". I ain't abusing nobody. I'm a little dude. But I always say, like, you know, women always get with dudes that are tall and good looking and they abuse them and shit. And I'd be like, damn, should have got with a short nerd. But they don't like short nerds because we don't pose a threat. They want to be with a nigga that can protect them and choke them out at the same time. Like, hey, baby, come get this work. Stroke my beard. Hey, bitch, my turkey leg's cold. Bop, 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 bop. And then they hit him with like a 4-piece. I ain't saying beat women up. I'm just saying, like, that's how I feel. That's how I view relationships. Me personally, I ain't got no girlfriend. Whatever I need is purchasable, obviously. I said that joke 100 times. But the real reason I don't have a girlfriend is because I got 2 cell phones and a PS4. Why the fuck am I squeeze a girl in the middle of all that? I got two cell phones and a PS4. That's so fucking important. Technology runs everything, nigga. Having two cell phones and a PS4 is like having three wives, nigga. How am I have a girlfriend and three wives? That's too much to manage. I don't want to handle all that shit. Fuck out of here. I ain't trying to put in extra work. Whatever. Whatever. I talk about what I want to talk about. Now I sound like John F. Kennedy. Yo, my bedroom is quiet as fuck. I got the best, like, noise. What you call it? Noise seclusion in my room. Like, it's so fucking quiet in here. It's peaceful. It's amazing. It's quiet. You can't hear shit. It's almost soundproof. I got a bunch of, like, egg cartons up around the corner of my room while I'm standing there. So everything sounds great. Everything just sounds so peaceful and nice in here. Super quiet. You can just sit in here and just sit in the abyss of silence. All you can hear is my voice. All you hear is my voice. Yeah. Also, I got another trick. Because you know around with voice? Moist. And I enjoy a nice, moist honey bun. And this is my new thing to do with honey buns. To make them taste the best that they're supposed to taste. I take a honey bun out of the vending machine in my job. And I put it in my pocket. I wear tight ass jeans. Because I'm a sexy boy. I put the honey bun in my pocket. And then I walk around while it's like 100 degrees outside. And while I'm walking around in 100 degree weather, it's like my thighs are hot. The sun is hot. And my jeans got the honey bun in clothes. So the honey bun's just cooking in my fucking pocket. It's just cooking. And I put my cell phone in the same pocket. Because all food tastes better with a little bit of cancer. So I got some cell phone in my honey bun. Got my thigh meat. And the heat from the sun all in the honey bun. And it's just cooking and cooking. And when I take it out and I eat it in the movie theater. Mouthgasm, nigga. Just, oh my God. It's so fucking scrumdiddlyumptious. That shit be having me like, oh my God. Like, this is the sound. That's a regular honey bun before I devour it. On Wednesday. Today, Monday. On Wednesday. I'm putting that motherfucker in my pocket. And I'm going to walk around. I'm going to go to the movies. And then I'm going to go do some comedy, tell some jokes. I don't know what movie I'm seeing yet because I already saw everything I wanted to see. I saw Stuber. Stuber was like a good old classic Buster Keaton type film. It was a good old classic. Like, it was a movie. The verbal jokes weren't the best. That's not a critic. The fucking slapstick was amazing. When they got in fights, like Kumail Nanjiani beating up Batista with sticks and bats is fucking hilarious. He hit the nigga in the head with a bicycle. That was so fucking funny. And at the beginning of the movie, Dave Batista, he hit Iko Uwais, he hit him in the head with a dresser drawer. Cause he was doing like kung fu, like ping kak silat fighting. And that was very cool to watch and see. I like that a lot. I like it a lot. Shout out to comedians I saw today. Saw a lot of funny comedians today. Sorry guys. I'm washing my ass rag right now. I keep an ass rag in between my ass cheeks at all time. I cut a little bit of fabric out of a t-shirt. And then I like, when it was clean and dry, I stuck it between my booty cheeks. Over my asshole to keep it clean. Everybody know I do this shit. Like a man pond. Catches all my farts. So then when I get home, take my drawers off, I flip them inside out, throw them in the corner of my room, and let them air out. And then when I get done with all my drawers that's piled up and aired in out, I wear them one more time, and then I wash them. Everything smells great. My ball sweat never smell like vinegar. My shit be smelling delightful, nigga. Your bowl is delightful, cause my shit is delightful. My shit is delightful. My shit is mighty full. My shit is like you're trying to get a nightful. A nightful. PM, not AM. Beats is what I'm not slaying. I don't smoke weed. I don't play sports, but I do smoke fools on the b-ball court. Wah, wah. Wah, wah. Wah, wah. Wah, wah. I'm gonna talk about some more shit to piss me off, but first, I'm gonna see if my food ready. Alright, hold on. Wait a minute. I'll be back. Chill out. Rest in peace, Tony Stark. Just saw Spider-Man Far From Home in 4DX. Definitely the best 4DX movie I've seen since Black Panther back in 2018. Like, this joint, they went all in. Like, they really went all in on this Spider-Man. Like, as far as Spider-Man, I'm not gonna rank it, but it's in the top two. Like, it's up there with, like, Spider-Verse and the O2 version. Like, it's, this one is better than Homecoming. It's up there. It might be the third. It might be tied up. I don't know. Far From, dude, Spider-Verse was the best one I've ever seen. But now you got Spider-Man 2002, and you got the Far From Home. I don't know. I can't. I'm not even gonna spoil it because it's that good. Dude, Spider-Man Far From Home is the shit. It's so fucking good. It's so fucking cool. Dope movie. Really dope movie. I got popcorn in my teeth. Yeah, man, they properly did Mysterio as well. Like, if you read the comic books or play the Spider-Man PS2, Spider-Man 2, based off the movie, if you play Spider-Man 2 on the PS2, Quentin Beck's on there, and, you know, yeah, you deal with him. And it's just, and it's like, oh, shit, there's, like, the twist. And in this movie, they have the twist, but the twist is amazing. It's the same twist, obviously. It's like, Quentin Beck is who he is. He is the guy who you know he is, if you know about him. But, like, the way they did the shit was very entertaining, very amazing. You know what's crazy about right now? I'm listening to a podcast while I'm doing a podcast. This is the craziest shit. Like, I'm listening to Dr. Drew talk to Eliza Schlesinger while I'm talking about Spider-Man. So I got two voices in my ear, and I'm putting the voice in your ear. It's weird. It's like Inception. Earception. I know, right? It's crazy. Go see that shit, though. It's tight, bro. It's amazing. I'm walking around outside right now with short sleeve shirts on. I'm wearing a short sleeve shirt right now while it's hot outside. I hate mosquitoes, but fortunately, none of them are biting me. I'm very lucky right now. I never walk outside with short sleeves. You see? I got short sleeves. I never walk around with my forearms out. That's what you call savagery. I never do this. But tonight I am. I should try to find somewhere to do comedy tonight. The DC, Maryland, Virginia comedy scene. It's good if you're friendly. I don't talk to a lot of people, so it's kind of a struggle for me. Because, like, it's Tuesday and I don't really have anywhere to do comedy at. Because I'm not cool with them like that. I gotta be friends and shit. Whatever, it's weird. I'm not complaining. I'm gonna just, like, study how to be charismatic. I'm gonna go to Charisma on Command on YouTube and watch all their videos and learn how to be a human being so I can act like I'm cool with people and be friendly. Because I'm not. I'm just a weird. I like to be by myself. But I'm gonna pretend. I'm gonna pretend like I know how to be around humans. And, like, hey, what's up, guys? Hey, wanna go grab drinks? Hey, Becky. The new pair of shoes, that's a cool skirt. Hey, like, I'm gonna try to be like that. Sociable, whatever you call it. Cause I prefer not to. I prefer to be myself, quiet, but whatever. I gotta learn how to be a human. I'm gonna just study Mark Zuckerberg and Tom Cruise cause they're trying to be human just like me, but they're succeeding at it. I'm struggling with trying to be human. I'll learn eventually, whatever. It's so hot and I'm wearing a short sleeve shirt. This is new for me. I never do this. I sound like one of those girls in the movies who do something slutty and say, I'm serious. I've never done this before. I never do this. I never behave like this. This is all brand new. I never do this. I never. But I'm gonna try to be human. Fuck it. God damn it. I gotta fake to get success. God damn it. Gotta be friendly and talk to people and shit. Gotta be all nice. Fuck. This is the struggle. This is the struggle. Ah, fuck. Should I have worn shades today? God damn. Stop capping. I'm really popping. How could I slip if I'm the one doing the mopping? No ballistics, no forensics. On the gang. Fuck. It's some good ass weather though. Good fucking weather, bruv. This is what you call good fucking weather. Especially if you got melanin. Did you got melanin? If you got no melanin, then you might want to stay in the house. Or get you some sunblock. I don't need sunblock. I was born with sunblock. Man, I still need it. You don't want to be a dark bloke with skin cancer. You got to remain healthy as much as possible. Take your health seriously. Tourists taking pictures of me. A couple of tourists just snapped a bunch of pics. I think they got me in the pics too. No complaints over here. Ooh, a big bench. This is the kind of bench that how many people like to sleep on? It's wooden. Might be weak though. Oh no, it's comfortable. I'm gonna sit on the bench. Yeah. I'm gonna wait. Wi-Fi outlets, eco-friendly safety. Outlets, Wi-Fi, eco-friendly safety. A lot of Caucasian girls out here. They got the yeets out. I think the yeets mean butts. I'm not sure. Wait a minute. I'm going to go away for a moment. I'm going to check the bus schedule. Oh, no. I forgot. I got the wrong accent. I'm going to check the bus schedule. The bus schedule, yeah. Then I'm gonna go home. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Alright, see you guys later. I don't know what's going on with nature right now, but like last year I walked past some ducks, and I never walked past ducks, but I was downtown in DC, and no, it was like 2 years ago, I think. 2018. I was walking around, it's cold as shit. And some ducks were next to I walked down the sidewalk, and like two ducks were walking on the sidewalk too. And I walked up to them and they didn't move. I thought birds flew away when you walked up to them, but they were a little bold. They stood there and just like kept on bobbing and walking how ducks do. It was some weird shit. And then like this whole fucking year, basically, I'm walking around outside just enjoying life. And I don't know what kind of bird you call it, like a regular bird, just regular bird, not pigeons, not falcons, not hawks or nothing, just regular birds, the kind we see all over the place. They just fucking like, they fly real low, like to like my neck level, and then I like go like this, and then they fly up, like they keep flying to, like they fly towards me, like they're trying to fuck with me, like birds keep trying to fuck with me for some reason. I don't know, but like birds, not falcons, just regular birds, they fly like real low, like they coming at me with their beaks, and like I don't want to fuck a bird up, I will if I have to, but they like fly like, and then I close my eyes and they go above me, I guess, or below me, I don't know, but something's going on with nature where like the animals are attacking people, like the animals are getting real bold, they don't fuck with humans no more. I doubt they're going to fuck with me because I'm not really a colonizer or a hunter, but just saying. Watch out for the birds. I even stopped eating chicken. I think since I stopped eating chicken, the bird like me now more because I don't eat chicken no more. Because, you know, chicken shrinks your dick. So I stopped eating chicken. They said, oh, this nigga cool. Let me run up on him and give him a high five on my wing. But I close my eyes and go like, yeah. And next thing you know, they go away. They go the opposite direction. So I'm cool with that. But still, watch out for these animals. They fucking getting crazy. And yesterday, I saw a pigeon. A pigeon was walking, and like I walked real close to him. Like I could have pet him, I could have kicked him, but he didn't move. Like I don't know what's going on. Maybe it's global warming, but I'm paying close attention to the animals. I'm paying close attention to the white supremacists that's killing people, and the animals. Something's going on. The global warming, the weather keeps changing. It keeps going from fucking like the climate change is crazy. It keeps going from like 95 degrees hot ass summer day, and then all the dark clouds just come to wherever I'm the fuck at. And it's just like hard rain, just fucking thunder, lightning, and like heavy showers. And then it all goes away.
and then the sun comes back, and it's like, it's tricky. It's like someone's fucking with the government's fucking with the weather machine, whatever. That's basically all I had to say right now. This is still Leroy Furycast. I'm just putting in little drop talks whenever I feel like talking about some shit. I just saw Spider-Man again. I noticed that it said The Amazing Spider-Man 143 on one of the tag numbers on the scene at the end with the bridge when they fucked the bridge up and the weather monster comes, the earth, air, fire, and water. I'll call it wind, but it's earth, air, fire, and water. When the earth, air, fire, and water culmination comes about and it fucks up the bridge, one of the flipped over cars in London on the bridge when Spider-Man and MJ kiss, it's a car upside down that says TASM 143. So I guess The Amazing Spider-Man 143 was the issue with Mysterio. I should pause this and look it up, and that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna pause it and look it up. Hold on, be patient. TASM 143, didn't find shit because I'm not a fucking nerd. Alright, I'll get back to the podcast later on. Goodbye. I just saw the movie Crawl. Crawl was really fun and exciting to watch. Alligators are dicks. Florida gators are definitely dicks. Florida is a crazy ass state full of crazy people, and the animals are assholes, like spiders, a dog, some rats, and alligators. That's the whole movie. It's all those animals, and it's the craziest shit in the world. I'm gonna get hit by a car. Who gives a fuck? Yeah, death is fake. Life is fake. Death is real. Whatever. There's another side. Whatever. I saw the movie. I saw Crawl. Alexander Aja. He did Evil Dead and Don't Breathe. Two other cool movies. He does cool movies. He does cool shit. I like Crawl. It was fun. It was like a really good movie in theaters. Like it belonged in theaters. And I saw it in theaters. And I squinched a lot because, like, alligators are dicks. They bite people. And like, they have strong ass teeth. Not strong as hyenas, but very strong. Speaking of hyenas, Eric Andre used to show pictures of his dick on Instagram, and now he's voicing a hyena in the Lion King movie. And that is very inspiring to me. I am inspired. Eric Andre inspires me. I'm inspired by a lot of light-skinned niggas. Lawrence Fishburne, Ty Mock, you know, because Furious Styles, and Bruce Leroy. Yeah, and Eric Andre. Got that light, and then Chris Brown. I'm listening to Chris Brown right now. Right now, I'm listening to Chris Brown's Strip. I don't know if you can hear it or not, but yeah, Crawl was cool. I enjoyed the fuck out of Crawl. Would I see it again in theaters? Yeah, I'd see it again. I saw Spider-Man twice. Why not see the alligators twice? It was like multiple alligators too. Like alligators are dicks, and I love alligators, but I don't love dicks. But if it wasn't for dicks, none of us would be here. And I have a dick, and I love mine, so I ain't gotta say pause. I'm talking about biology. Whatever. I see a nice pair coming my way in a pink top. Whatever. It's cool. I ain't tripping at all. This girl booty out of control. Back it up and down that pole. I'ma get my kick on. Get my freak on. If you ain't freaking, we ain't speaking. We ain't playing. No, I'm not. I'm about to go see Incredibles 2 in a park if it's not over already. I think I missed it. I already got it on my laptop because I support movies. Whatever. I ain't tripping off shit. I ain't tripping off shit and I gotta take a shit. Oh boy, my Friday is lit. And all that rhyme. And I don't have to go to work on Saturday or Sunday. So every day is gonna be a motherfucking fun day. Fun day. What rhymes with fun day? Zunday? Tay Zunday? Chocolate rain? Chocolate rain, get your pain. Ooh, I'm out. I saw today The Art of Self-Defense. Jesse Eisenberg, Riley Stearns is the director and writer. It was a wild ass movie. That shit was crazy. It was a action movie. It was a dark comedy. It was funny as fuck. Like Jesse Eisenberg, like this nigga is like, he's such a good actor. Like Zombieland, Cursed, when he was a werewolf with Christina Ricci. Dude, this movie is really funny. It's funny as fuck. And the violence is good, real violence. It's like Barry. You know the show Barry? Bill Hader? It's like Bill Hader's Barry show. But it's all like hand-to-hand combat. And the dude Giovanni I forgot the nigga name, but he playing Chris Moltisanti's father in the Saints of Newark, the Sopranos movie. He played Sensei Wesley. Imogen Poots played Anna. She was the brown belt instructor who deserved to be a black belt, but Sensei Leslie would never let her become a black belt because he was an asshole. He was a manipulator. I feel like I'm not good at reviewing movies. I'm just breaking them down. But spoiler alert, it's fucking dope. It's a cool ass movie. It's fucking really, it's really entertaining. It's funny as hell. The Art of Self-Defense might be the funniest movie I've seen this year. The way shit was just so ridiculously crazy. Like, everyone's crazy in the movie. Like, I was watching it, I was saying to myself, like, Imogen Poots character, I feel like in interviews she can get asked constantly, do you like playing Anna? Isn't she a strong female character? This is how I feel about the characters in the movie. None of the characters are strong. They're all just lunatics. Everyone's a fucking psychopath in the movie. So Anna is not a strong female character. She's fucking mentally damaged by Sensei Leslie. Sensei Leslie was a great character in the, just watch the movie. The Art of Self-Defense. This is my review of the movie. Review breakdown. Dude, I'm walking past some woman's house with 1,000 shoes in the closet. Jesus Christ. How many shoes do you need? Fucking broads. Fucking broads in their kicks. Who am I? Freckles. Ugh. This light is too bright for my face. I should turn it down. But I can't because I got melanin. Oh! Do I need more lights? Then maybe I can see my face. Too many lights. I'm relaxed. I'm chilling. I'm walking through a super expensive neighborhood right now. I can't afford to live here. That's why I'm walking through the motherfucker. I ain't fucking none of the hoes out here. So I'm walking through the motherfucker. I ain't stopping off nowhere. I'm going to keep moving through the motherfucker. Well, now I'm walking into this scaffolding. Is this called a scaffolding? It's just like planks and poles, planks and poles, poles and planks. Your mama left titty stank. You need to get money out of the bank because your basement smells like the gasoline from an army tank. And if you get the money out the bank, you can pay and repair the water damage in your house after the hurricane, whatever. I'm talking complete nonsense right now. And I just got a Mentos because I was doing comedy at Habana Village. Shout out to Xavier Montez. I was doing comedy out there, and I was talking to a lot of people. And I feel like my breath smelled like ass. It didn't taste bad, but I feel like it smelled like a little bit of ass. So I went and bought some Mentos. Not like I'm talking to anybody else the rest of the night. I'm going to go home, say what's up for my father and shit. That's about it. I ain't been talking in a while. But still, I don't like having, just in case, like, a beautiful woman walks up to me and says, hey, papi, you look good. And I say, where are you from? She says, I am from Germany, but I have this accent because I am weird. I'm like, all right, cool. It's whatever. I don't discriminate. If the face don't match the accent, I don't care. Shakira looks like a Caucasian, but she is a Colombian. All right, now it's too quiet. It's so quiet out here. I feel like I'm in the studio because it's so quiet. Like, when you're in the studio, it sounds great. The audio sounds terrific. And right now, the audio is terrific. You want to know where I am? There's a gate. Is that a surprise? Who knows? I can't decide. If something's live, King Wizard. Shout out to Kid Cudi. Shout out Mental Illness. Hey, Zach Fox is fucking funny. I think he's a comedian. I don't know if he's a stand-up, but he's funny as shit. Like, when he raps and when he talks on, like, interviews, he's a fucking hilarious guy. Like, that song, Square Up, and the other song, Jesus Is The One, I Got Depression, that nigga got bars. Talking about stick his dick in the bag of Doritos and make a nigga bitch suck the dust off the tip. I wish I thought of that. Like, I'm so angry I didn't think of that. That's a really cool orange and black bike. It sure wouldn't match my Orioles hat. Ah! Look at that mural. It's a cute little mural. Someone's in their car listening to Petey Pablo. I don't know. I'm walking past a group of guys. Let me. I'm walking past a group of four young guys. I'm gonna hit pause. And if you see me again, I'm still alive. I made it out alive. Nothing happened. They were just roasting some guy across the street. I was scared. Four young guys. Young dudes know kung fu. Alright. I know kung fu. I'll call the cops on you. I'll call the authorities. You kids, get off my lawn. Get off my friggin' lawn, kids. You children. I should make this video landscape mode and not portrait mode. Excuse me for 1 second. Yeah, I be listening to Shawn Mendes and shit. I listen to Shawn Mendes and Billie Eilish. I feel like I'm Asian backwards. Cause I'm 25 years old, and I always listen to shit that's my age. But now I feel like I'm going into the new shit. Yo, it's somebody in the house. People got their blinds open, so I'm just looking at people's houses while I'm walking by. Oh, they're playing football. They're playing, women are playing soccer over there. Of course, I'm trying to see if I can look at any butts. They're playing soccer. They got like flammy baggy shorts on. They ain't really got the compression shorts on. That's more of a volleyball thing. When girls play volleyball, you can see the juice, the jelly. You can see the jelly. You can really see the jelly when the girls play volleyball. All right, now I'm a little lost. I just gotta find out. I know where to go. All right, I thought I was lost. I feel like this is hiking with Kevin Nealon, but it's hiking with Leroy Furious, and I don't have any guests. I should have fucking told a comedian, hey, walk with me the long way. We could do a podcast together, but I don't fucking know how to socialize with people. I'm just walking by myself, talking by myself, shitting. Walking around, going wherever I want. This is low-key, high-key dangerous. Like, I'm just walking around a fucking city with my phone out, talking. But, I got my eyes open. My eyes and my ears are wide the fuck open. Like, I have headphones on, but I ain't listening to shit. I'm just walking around. Looking at my fucking reflection. Like Mulan and shit. When will my reflection show who I am inside? That new Mulan looks dope. Asian people, they're killing it with the movies. Like, Disney and shit. Like, Shang-Chi. Never heard of that. Never heard of Shang-Chi. But I'm hyped for it, because nigga got a pet monkey. Like, he do kung fu. It's a kung fu Marvel movie. Iron Fist Season 2 was dope. So, Shang-Chi should be a dope movie. Marvel and Disney, they come together like butt cheeks. They make great-ass kung fu. I'm good with the words, nigga. Ooh, I got the mojo with the movies. Like, Austin Powers with the boobies. Because he bangs a lot of chicks. Oh, liquor and beer. Pizza. Another restaurant, kebab, wings, salads, gyro meat. Another restaurant, another bar. Everyone's drunk. No one's sober. No one's sober. Oh, fuck. I gotta get home. It's good. This breeze feels amazing. It was like 85 degrees today, which is cool. But before that, yesterday, it was like 70 degrees, I think. It was 80. Yesterday was 70-something. Today is 80-something. And I think the 80 went down to 60 because it's a little nippy. But it's not a bad nippy. It's not like a bad nippy. It's not like nippy weather. It's not like, oh my God, it's freezing. My nipples are poking through my shirts. Oh, golly gee, Willikers, fat man. I need some warmth. It's not like that. And now I smell shit. Did I step in shit? All these fucking dogs around here. This is why I wear a Vic jersey. Oh, time to go. This is why I wear a Michael Vick jersey when I go most places. I like to keep gentrifiers in check. Everyone walking their fucking Shiba Inus. In their fucking little Dobermans. In their fucking little, you know, Huskies. In their little, what's the other one? What's that small dog called? Watch out for rats. Watch out for motherfucking rats. Keep your motherfucking heart, 3 stacks. Keep your motherfucking heart. I said, keep your heart, 3 stacks. Keep your heart. I said, yo, people have no curtains. This is that Dutch shit. This is that Dutch tradition for people to have no curtains open and no blinds on their windows. just the eyes are the windows to the soul, and the windows are the eyes to your house, and nigga, I see everything from your bed to your couch. Yiddy! I'm an old black man from the 70s. Why am I calling myself black? I'm not a color. I am an old Moorish brother from the 70s in the body of a 25-year-old. Because I don't play sports, obviously, because I ain't with that shit. I'd rather own the team, but I do have a 25-year-old's body. Like, I'm walking very far right now, and I didn't break a sweat yet because it's 70 degrees out. But the day before yesterday, like, today was 80, now it's 70, high 60, or low 60. And yesterday it was 70, but the day before that, nigga, 105. And the day before that, nigga, like, 99. Like, the fucking global warming shit getting out of hand. I keep flipping the camera around so I can see where I'm walking. I don't want to, like, trip over a brick and break my fucking teeth. I don't want to break my, like, jaw and my face and my phone. But then I got to pay a dental bill. And I got to get cosmetic surgery, like, from a plastic surgeon. And then I got to buy a new cell phone because I got to watch my porn somehow. Oh, Jesus Christ. Podcasting sure is expensive. I'm not vlogging right now. I'm podcasting. This is a podcast. This is a podcast. I'm going to put it on YouTube. R.I.P. to the chair with the three wheels. I meant to say five, not three wheels. Shout out to that basketball player, Spree Will. I see a cafe. That's okay. I see another liquor store. That's not okay. Everyone wants to get drunk, and I ain't really complaining because I don't skunk. I am not a skunk. I am not a crook. I read a couple of books. Do the beat about the book. Hug at the hug at the hook. Japanese market, that's okay.
And then
some places are okay. Some places are like, oh no. Some places are okay. Some places are, oh no. If I want to learn how to fight, I got to visit a dojo. But not the one from The Art of Self-Defense. That's an amazing movie. The Art of Self-Defense. Back to The Art of Self-Defense. Riley Stearns, Jesse Eisenberg, I wear condoms so my dick doesn't burn. Those, that's a crazy fucking movie. Everyone should go see that movie. It's really dope. It's really crazy. The ending is fucking amazing. The ending is so, it's the best. The ending, like, you kind of see it coming, but you don't see it coming the way they do it. It's like, oh shit, I saw that coming, but it didn't happen like that. I thought it was going to be a different way. It's really good. Jesse Eisenberg should do a podcast with Chris Hardwick or Marc Maron or me and talk about The Art of Self-Defense, because more people should know about this movie. It's amazing. It's like my favorite non-superhero movie of the year. It's like right under Fighting With My Family and somewhere is teetering above and below Shazam, because Shazam was amazing. Shazam! Zachary Levi. I don't even wear the nigga jeans, but he cool. That's a cool ass movie. Shazam! Damn. Whatever. See, I could just sit in my chair at home and podcast from my studio, but, you know, why would I podcast from my studio when I could just podcast on the quiet ass streets because everyone's indoors and everyone has their eyes glued to their phone? Like, I'm using my phone right now, but I'm looking everywhere else. Ooh, a suit store. I don't wear suits and shit. What's that? Anti-aging and wellness. You old bitches trying to look young. That shit don't work. You got to drink some water. You got to drink water and wear lotion. I ain't talking about that bullshit. Like, what that fucking lotion that, like, new strippers wear? I forgot what it's called. Aveeno? Yeah, that bullshit. Don't wear that. You got to use something with cocoa in it. Coconut oil, cocoa butter, something with cocoa. That keeps your skin proper. That's how I look like I'm 12 when I'm 25. I was at a comedy show just now. Motherfucking Anthony Oakes, shout out to him. He's hilarious. He told the audience, he's like, all the beautiful people make some noise. I started making noise. And Jelani, he a funny comedian too. Fat motherfucker. He gonna say, sit down, calm down. No. If somebody say all the beautiful people make noise, I'm gonna be the loudest one in the room, alright? Well, tell me I ain't beautiful. You fucking kidding me? I ain't ugly. If I ain't beautiful, at least I'm like, I'm funny looking. Oh, look at that rat, look at that rat, look at the rat, look at the rat. I saw a rat. Oh, that's a mouse. I be wanting to feed mice sometimes. Look at this public display of affection. This guy's kissing his girlfriend, and she looks just like Arietta Adams. She's cool. Yeah, oh, time to go. Cha-cha-cha. Slide, slide, slide. 15 seconds or I'm gonna die. Cause I ain't vehicle proof. And you smell bad because you boof. It's really a hot girl summer. Y'all going crazy. City boys, they relax. They're chilling. Just winning. But hot girl, the hot girl summer, y'all women are loco. Alright, I'm about to wrap this shit up. I'm getting around a lot of people now. It was quiet over there in the neighborhood section. But now, oh, today's date is July 24th. Today's July 24th. Yeah. I'm chilling. Let y'all go here. I'm relaxed. I'm good. Nails and spa, beauty enhancements. It's a lot of beauty things and it's a lot of people trying to look good. Yeah, you just gotta be yourself. Shave your own face. Get enough rest at night. Get your 6 to 5 hours. Everyone's not gonna get 8. Everyone's not gonna get 8. I get 5 on the nose. I get 5 hours on the nose. If I get more than 5 hours, then I may well get like 11 hours. I get like 5 or 11, no in between. I'm sleeping or I'm awakened. No in between. One or the other. I gotta make up my mind. This weather is amazing. Yeah, I'm wrapping it up. There's too many people around. I feel crazy. And my right eye is blind because this light is bright as fuck. I'm gonna be like Popeye. Hallucinating. And shit. Oh, no, I'm going to keep talking because people aren't around me anymore. Another bakery. I'm looking at all the businesses. You know. Bakery, Bread Bite. I see something that says, fuck Trump, Obama all day. Eh, it's your opinion. That's cool. That's cool. I don't talk about politics. A day spa and nails. See, I fuck with day spas. That shit tight. Another pizza restaurant. Gas station. I don't drive. Who gives a fuck? I don't need the gasolina. Your ice basura, my ice horchata. Your ice is basura, my ice horchata. I can't say the last part because Cardi B trademarked that, but I'll say, oh, cruh, 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 cruh. I don't want to get sued. And men shouldn't be good at doing the Cardi B saying thing. Stop the raids, close the camps, keep families together. Stop the raids. Hashtag stop the raids. I ain't getting deported. I'm from Virginia. We're going to take you out from where you live and put you in Northern Virginia. You got to go where you're born at. Oh, I got to go to Northern Virginia? Oh, man. You mean the place where there's like an airport so I can go anywhere else and I can still go to the movies and do stand-up comedy? Oh, man. That sucks. Trump is an ass. All right. I don't see anyone wearing the only Trump I fuck with is Tiana. I'm not like really, I don't want her to, but if she does, like if I meet her and she wants to do something fun, I'm all for it. I'm game. I don't mind being a part of Tiana Trump's body count. I don't mind it. If she allows me to do it, she allows me to do it. Go with it. No complaints. No complaints. No complaints. Go with it. I'm all right. I'm cool with it. She's a nice looking young lady. Little too nasty for my taste, but hey, teacher's own. I'll still take a bite out of that apple. By apple, I mean asshole. I would eat Tiana Trump's ass. And she can suck my cock, and we can bang each other. Well, she can't bang me, but you know what I mean. B and the V, simple. All right. Oh, I just really found out about Meg Thee Stallion. Like, I heard about her, seen her, but I didn't discover her. She's 5'10". With a fucking fat ass. She's a literal stallion. And that's where I'm gonna end this portion of the podcast. I lied. I'm going to keep talking. Meg the Stallion is a literal stallion. She's 5'10". Then she wears heels to make her fat ass get more insinuated and be fatter. Meg the Stallion is a literal stallion. She's a fucking minotaur. I'm into that. I'm into supernatural bestiality. Not regular bestiality, but supernatural bestiality. All right? If I see a female griffin, that's a lion with wings and a beak. If I see a lioness like Nala with a beak, I'm banging. Raw. We're having babies. Big head, locky hair, flying, beak-ridden, lion body babies. And that's why I'm ending the podcast. Meg the Stallion is a literal stallion. I wouldn't mind banging. She's supernatural. She's beautiful. I'm out.
I'm happy to help.
I'm Audi 5000. Just like the Huff brothers from Step Brothers. And that's it.
This is my podcast. This is my podcast. Leroy Furious. The Leroy Fury Cast. This is my podcast. This is my podcast. This is my. I say what the fuck I want, bitch.